Microsoft Teams has so many different features and settings that sometimes you might not know that there are certain things you can do in Microsoft Teams that are really cool. And in this video, we're going to look at 8 of those cool features. Now, if you like tips on Teams and that sort of thing, subscribe to the channel because I do have a number of videos on the channel on how to use Microsoft Teams. But in this video, we're going to look at 8 mysterious little features that I think you're going to really enjoy knowing about. Tip number 1. Let's make things a little bit more visually appealing by using emojis. Here I'm going in, I'm going to create a new channel. When I create a new channel, let's call it equipment. So I'm going to create a channel for our outdoor equipment. To add an emoji on a Mac, if I hit Control Command Spacebar, it'll bring up the emoji menu. On some Apple keyboards, there's actually the world icon in as a function key that'll bring it up. But on all Macs, if you hit Control Command Spacebar, it'll bring up the different emojis. So let's go ahead and type in camping, and you'll notice that it'll bring up the different emojis that are related to camping. So I'll choose this one, I quite like it, and it'll add it into the name of the channel. A bonus tip, tip 1.5 if you would, you can also make this a private team if you want, but that's an extra tip. So I'll go ahead and add this in here, and you'll notice that now I'm going to have underneath my team here, I'm going to have an equipment channel with a little tent and a tree here. Now be a little bit careful on this because if I go to add another channel, so let's go add another channel in here, and this channel here I'm going to talk, let's say it's zoo. Now we're not going to go to the zoo, but let's say I'll put in some sort of animal emoji in here. So we'll say, okay, we're going to go look at, something like, I guess we'll look at a cow at the zoo. That's a strange zoo, but we'll go in here and we'll go zoo. The only reason I'm putting in zoo is because I want it to begin with a Z. So I'm going to go add, but notice it does not put it into the channel alphabetically, because these emojis actually do have an alphabetical sort order to them, but you don't really know what it is, so you can get unpredictable results. So my tip would be, first of all, to use the icons, tip number 1, and second of all, to make sure that you're putting them at the end of your channel name and not at the beginning. Tip number 2. Instead of scheduling a meeting within a channel where I only have the options of meet now or schedule a meeting, go to the calendar to schedule your meetings. When you go to the calendar to schedule your meetings, you'll be given the option of scheduling the meeting, creating a webinar, or a live event. Now, scheduling a meeting will allow you to do all of the things you'd expect. You can put in the name of the meeting, you can have it repeat, you can choose what channel it goes into. If instead we choose to go to a webinar, however, what we can do is the same exact thing in terms of going in and scheduling it, but we can create a registration form so that people are able to go in and register for this webinar. That's a great thing to do in advance of a meeting where I want to invite people into it. The third option here, so I'll just go and discard this. The third option is to create a live event. Live events are quite interesting because now I can even allow external presenters to come into this event. So you'll see that tip number 2, we get a lot more options when it comes to working with meetings in the calendar view as opposed to in the team view where we're limited. Tip number 3, set up voicemail. So if I go into the call menu here and I go into my don't forward here, I can go into more settings. Underneath more settings, underneath calls, you'll notice that I can configure voicemail. So I'm going to go in. There's a few things you can do here in terms of forwarding calls, but for this tip, it's set up your voicemail. So when I go into voicemail, I can go in and even type in a greeting here. So I could say, hello there, I'm not available at the moment. So you can type this in and it will actually put this text to speech. The other option you have is you can actually record your greeting. What this will do is bring up the dial pad. So it takes a few moments, but a dial pad will come up. And now you can go in to your keypad and just like a telephone, you can go in and change your personal greetings and record a personal greeting. Tip number 4, you can add third-party file storage. So if I go into files, you'll notice that OneDrive is there as a cloud storage, but if I go down to add cloud storage, you can add many of these popular file storage options. So for example, you can add a Dropbox account, or very common is a Google Drive account. So you can add these storage accounts into Microsoft Teams to give access to your team members to the shared files in those cloud storage accounts. Tip number 5 has to do with chat. Underneath chat, you'll notice that I had this conversation with Diana Prince. That's Wonder Woman, by the way. And what we can do within any of the chats is we can pop out the chat. This is very useful if you have multiple conversations occurring at the same time, because now I can treat this chat as a separate entity and I can have this pop out chat window, which makes things a lot easier to organize, a lot more convenient. Tip number 6 is quite interesting because I can go into the ellipse next to my name, go into settings, and go into devices. Underneath devices, I can choose the devices I'm using, but here I can also turn on high-fidelity music mode. I have a podcast that I've just recently started called The Learning Mindset, and one of the things I hope to do on that podcast is have a Teams meeting with other people and interview them about how the science of learning and practice of learning occurs. So in this case here, I want to make sure that I get the best audio I can turn on high-fidelity music mode. It also allows me to enable echo cancellation if I'm having some challenges there as well. So this is a very useful tool if you need to record and want to maintain high fidelity audio. Tip number 7 is a very useful one. If I hit the ellipse and go into keyboard shortcuts, I'm on a Mac for this video, so you can see all the different keyboard shortcuts that I have for a Mac. Now you'll notice here that I have to scroll and there's no way for me to easily print this off. I use a software product called Snagit that will allow me to do a scrolling capture. But if you don't have that available, if you want to get all these commands and print them off to have them handy, you can click on the C shortcuts for all platforms and it'll bring up the web page. So you could then print off the web page. You'll notice that here are all the different keyboard shortcuts for the Mac. And if I go to the top here, here are all the keyboard shortcuts for Windows. Very, very handy, very useful. Yes, Microsoft, that was useful information. I guess it resolved my issue. Okay, so there we have the keyboard shortcuts, which was tip number 7. Tip number 8 is an interesting tip if you have individuals that are going to be in charge of a certain aspect of your organization. Let me show you what I mean. If I go into the Coastal Hiking Club, let's say that Bruce Wayne is really in charge of a lot of hiking events that occur. So I'm going to go into the ellipse here and I'm going to tag this team. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a tag and I'm going to say, you know, in this case here, it's a hiking. So Bruce Wayne does a lot with hiking. He does a lot with camping. So underneath here, this tag here is, you know, who likes hiking. So we know who likes hiking here. And I can add names in here. So let's say Bruce Wayne likes hiking. So we'll put him in here. Then when I create this tag, I'm now going to be able to search for that tag. So if I search for the hiking tag, what's going to happen is you'll notice this is a description of who likes hiking. You can see who likes hiking in here. You can go in and you can actually click on that tag and you can see Bruce Wayne is here. I could even go and start chatting with him about hiking. Obviously, the more you tag and the more people that are involved in different aspects of the organization, the more valuable this resource becomes. But it's an unusual tip that a lot of people are unaware of. There are also a number of really great tips that we have when we're working with Microsoft Teams meetings. Don't forget to check out my videos on those. Now for this video, I'm going to demonstrate using a Mac computer, but if you're a Windows user, I also have the same video, but demonstrating on a Windows computer. There's something for everybody here on this channel, so let's go have a look at working with Microsoft Teams and 8 super cool features that you might not have known about. And there you have 8 cool tips that you can use with Microsoft Teams. And which one was your favorite? I'd really like to know. Did you already know about these different settings and features? Or is this something where you've discovered something new that you're now going to use in your own Teams environments? Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, like, and do all those YouTube-y things. Really appreciate it. Take care. Oh, and share with people. That's super helpful if you want to help out the channel. I really appreciate that. We'll see you in the next video.